Very good morning to all the students of class 10th D. Yes, beta. Today we'll be completing this chapter, hopefully. Find the 100 dresses part 1. Okay, so I have written value points. The very first day when we started this chapter, we just understood the characters and the background of the story. By the time everyone is joining, I'm just telling you. And second day, we understood the storyline and the theme. I wrote various themes yesterday, that discrimination, one should empathize with others, find discrimination on the basis of background, and you can say the luxurious life we see and the kind of dress we see, and start judging people, judgmental attitude of people. Fine. So various themes we discussed yesterday. And today we will be completing the chapter. For that, I have written value points. Before proceeding to value points, let's have a look at the quote of the day. As I always say, it takes courage to show up and become who you really are. It means there are many people, most of us, we keep on hiding our identity, that sometimes we just pretend something else, but reality is far away from the, you can say, what we pretend. There's a huge gap between the two. So it takes courage to show and become who you really are. Find Vanda Petronsky, coming from such humble background, fine, wearing same dress on daily basis. And every time Peggy would ask the same question to her, how many dresses did you say you have? And she would confidently say, 100 dresses all lined up in my closet. How many shoes did you have, Vanda? 60 pair of shoes all lined up in my closet. This was the innocent answer given by Vanda Petronsky. Now, the question is, why she would say she had 100 dresses if she was wearing single dress on daily basis, the blue faded dress. So let's have a look at the value points. Then I would be showing that video which you have been waiting for. So today we will be reading. Maddie wrote a note for Peggy asking to stop teasing Vanda. I told you Madeline was also a poor girl. Madeline or Maddie, one and same name, fine. So Maddie's best friend of Peggy, and she does not like when Peggy keeps on teasing Vanda on the grounds of dress or boots and such kind of things. So because she herself hails from poor background, so she wanted to, you know, tell this girl Vanda that we should not mock at others. And now they have noticed that Vanda Petronsky has not been coming to school, fine, for a few days. So Maddie wrote a note for Peggy asking to stop teasing Vanda. She would be writing a note that don't do this. Now it's over. That's enough is enough. When she starts writing, and immediately Maddie tears the note, imagining herself to be mocked at. So next Maddie thought that if I give this note to my friend, and what if she herself along with other friends start making fun of me instead of Vanda, because Vanda has not been coming to school. Fine. So she imagines herself at this position, and she tears the note and throws it away. So she did not say anything at all. Then next point is, Maddie then thinks of drawing competition. Fine. There was one very prestigious competition. Everyone would wait for that after every year. And boys would draw, find some craft, you can say aircraft designs and all, they would be telling you in the chapter. And for girls, the competition was about drawing the dresses, right? She keeps on thinking, who would win the competition, what will I draw and all. Then she thought Peggy would definitely win. So Peggy has good drawing skills. She can just draw by seeing the picture of a celebrity in the newspaper. She's very good at drawing. So she thinks that Peggy and Maddie both think that again, that Peggy would make it. She would be the one to win the competition. But Vanda wins the prestigious competition. If you can see, I have written by submitting 100 drawings of dresses. So this is the, you can say, conclusion of today's chapter, which we are going to read thoroughly. But you will read it, beta, because there are informations which could not be written on board. Vanda wins the prestigious competition by submitting 100 drawings of dresses. So we should not think low about others by seeing the, you can say, attire. We should not be judgmental about others. Everyone has been blessed by God, you know, with one or the other trait or quality. But we keep on, you know, wasting our time in showing up what doesn't even matter. Right? So let's have a look at that video, which I'm going to show you all, and you are going to relish it. So this is the scene where we'd be seeing a classroom scene, beta, how she was being mocked at by.
In the story, there was a post born in one. She had a real name. She wore the same dress every day, the faded blue. That shabby perfume. Two girls named Peggy and Maddie made fun of Wanda. In fact, Peggy teased her and Maddie just stood silent because Maddie was too poor. She didn't want to be teased with Wanda. Let's see the girl.
Fine, so this is just introduced here that how she was being teased by they're going to show you.
Let's make some fun of Wanda. Wanda, how many dresses did you say you had? 100. Yeah. 100. I'll still buy that. Yeah. I'll sell it at times. Velvet too. Yeah. Velvet too. 100. Dresses are lined up in my closet. Okay, Wanda. Now you can go.
So now you see how she's laughing. So this is a joke for Peggy and other kids also. And also sometimes, this is another scene.
60 pairs. All of them, no. Every pair is different. Different colors are lined up in my closet.
Peggy was not really clear. She just was fun with her and never let her cry.
Maddie was really unhappy when Peggy asked such questions with Wanda. Peggy is doing wrong to Wanda.
So you can see, beta, this is Madeline, the character of Madeline or Maddie. Now we have already discussed that she's thinking of stopping her friend, that she should not make fun of Wanda. So she's thinking that this should be stopped.
Could you stop making fun of Wanda? But I can't tell you. What if she start making fun of me?
Once Maddie started to write a letter to Peggy, but she couldn't afford to give it. There was a drawing and coloring contest. For boys, it was for designing motorboats.
So for boys, it was designing motorboats, and for girls, it was designing dresses.
It was for designing dresses. It was the day of contest.
Do you think Miss Mason will announce the winners today? Oh, I hope so. When you get it in, of course you will win that. Hope so.
And when they entered the classroom, they were surprised.
So I won't be sharing further. Fine. We will continue our reading first because we have to continue. Fine. Then after that, what happened next, I would be showing you in the video. Okay. So today, even though we have beta already done these oral comprehension check yesterday only. Fine. Those who have joined very late, let me tell you, we have read so far page 67 and we have done these question answers yesterday only. Now we are going to read from this page onwards. So I would be increasing my speed now, beta. Today, even though they had been late to school, Maddie was glad she had not had to make fun of Gwenda. She worked her arithmetic problems absent-mindedly. 8 times 8, let's see, she wished she had the nerve to write Peggy a note because she knew she never would have the courage to speak right out to Peggy to say, "Hey, Peg, let's stop asking Gwenda how many dresses she has." When she finished her arithmetic, she did start a note to Peggy. Suddenly, she paused and shuddered. She pictured herself in the schoolyard, a new target for Peggy and the girls. Peggy might ask her where she got the dress that she had on. And Maddie would have to say it was one of Peggy's old ones that Maddie's mother had tried to disguise with new trimmings so no one in room 13 would recognize it. So this is the first point which I've written on the board already, that Madeline is thinking, she's doing her arithmetic, she's solving her arithmetic problems, and side by side she's thinking that she would say it to Peggy, that she should not, you know, mock at Wanda Petronsky. But then she thought, I'm not able to talk or say directly, so I would be writing a note. But then suddenly she imagines herself that they would be making fun of her old dresses, you know, that she would wear old dresses. So then she gives up this idea and she tears the note off. If only Peggy would decide of her own accord to stop having fun with Wanda. Oh well, Maddie ran her hand through her short blonde hair as though to push the uncomfortable thoughts away. What difference did it make? Slowly, Maddie tore into bits the note she had started. She was Peggy's best friend, and Peggy was the best liked girl in the whole room. Peggy could not possibly do anything that was really wrong, she thought. So it was a justification, actually. Madeline did not have courage enough to stop her friend. You know, true friendship is when we should stop our friends also from doing wrong. It's not always that you keep on being a companion to your friends, even if they are doing wrong. You should sometimes stop them also if they are wrong. So here, Madeline is wrong. She did not say anything. She tears the note and she thinks that Peggy would make the decision whether she would be teasing Wanda or not. Okay. Now, as for Wanda, she was just some girl who lived upon Boggins Heights and stood alone in the schoolyard. She scarcely ever said anything to anybody. The only time she talked was in schoolyard about her 100 dresses. Maddie remembered her telling about one of her dresses, pale blue with colored trimmings, and she remembered another that was brilliant jungle green with a red sash. You would look like a Christmas tree in that, the girls had said in pretended admiration. So now here Madeline is thinking the only time she has seen Wanda talking was about 100 dresses only. And while talking about dresses, she would tell that how she had one pale blue colored dress with trimmings on it, how she had a jungle green colored with red sash. And girls would say that when you will wear that dress, you will look like a Christmas tree only. Fine, others would make fun of Wanda, but they never knew that this girl, Wanda, is very innocent and she is very good at drawing. And she was drawing those dresses at home in different colors. Thinking about Wanda and her 100 dresses all lined up in the closet, happened. Wait. Yes, Beta, there was some problem in the screen sharing. So that's why I stopped and tried again. Yes, Beta, now you can see. The next eight was thinking then, I told you that, oh, Maddie was sure Peggy would win. Okay, thinking about Wanda and her 100 dresses all lined up in the closet, Maddie would begin to wonder, who was going to win the drawing and coloring contest? For girls, this contest, underline better this. For girls, this contest consisted of designing dresses, and for boys, of designing motorboats. Fine? While telling you in the board, I forgot the motorboats. Fine? And probably Peggy would win the girls' medal. Peggy drew better than anyone else in the room. So Madeline is quite sure that Peggy would win this competition because she's very good at drawing. At least that's what everybody thought. She could copy a picture in a magazine or some film star's head so that you could almost tell who it was. It means Peggy was very good at drawing. She could copy, you can say, caricatures. Caricatures are the faces, you can say. She would see one magazine and newspaper and she would draw the picture of that actor. Fine, almost you can recognize it. So she was very good at drawing. So everybody was thinking among girls, Peggy is going to win. And Maddie was sure Peggy would win. Well, tomorrow the teacher was going to announce the winners. Then they would know. Last paragraph of this page. The next day it was drizzling. Maddie and Peggy hurried to school under Peggy's umbrella. Obviously, Peggy was having umbrella. Maddie was too poor to afford it. Naturally, on a day like this, they did not wait for Wanda Petronsky on the corner of Oliver Street. The street that far, far away under the railroad tracks and up the hill led to Boggins Heights. Anyway, they were not taking chances on being late today because today was important. So on daily basis, they would wait for Wanda so that they can have fun. But that day it was drizzling, it was raining. So they decided they won't be waiting and they would be straight away going to class because it was day of announcement that who's going to make it. Do you think Miss Mason will announce the winners today? So next character here is Miss Mason, the teacher. Fine. So Peggy is asking Madeline that do you think Miss Mason will announce the winners today? Oh, I hope so. The minute we get in, said Maddie, of course, you will win, Peg. So Maddie is saying, yes, definitely she will announce. And of course, you are the winner. Hope so, said Peggy eagerly. So Peggy is very excited about it. She's also hoping that she would win. The minute they entered the classroom, now, beta, listen carefully. They stopped short and gasped, means with wide mouth open. And they were so, excited, but they at that time, they were, you can say, startled. Why they were startled? There were drawings all over the room, on every ledge, every windowsill, dazzling colors and brilliant, lavish designs, all drawn on great sheets of wrapping paper. There must have been 100 of them, all lined up. Now you got your answer. These dresses belong to Wanda Petronsky. These must be the drawings. They were not real dresses. Now you remember, she would say that 100 dresses all lined up. Actually, these dresses were the drawings she has drawn. These must be the drawings for the contest. Now when Maddie and Peggy entered the room, they thought they are the drawings of the contest of all the students. They were, yes, they were. Everybody stopped and whistled or murmured admiringly. Everybody was admiring, even the boys. As soon as the class had assembled, Miss Mason announced the winners. When everybody was in the class, Miss Mason made announcement. Jack Bagels, underline beta, Jack Bagels among the boys, had won for the boys, she said, and his design for an outboard motor was an exhibition in room 12, along with the sketches by all other boys. So room number 12 was having the drawings of all the boys and room number 13 was having all the drawings of all the girls. As for the girls, she said, although just one or two sketches were submitted by most of the girls, but one girl, and room 13 should be proud of her. This one girl actually drew 100 designs, all different and all beautiful. In the opinion of judges, any one of the drawings is worthy of winning the prize. So when all the 100 dresses were submitted, the judges of that competition, they were so confused. They say that winner will definitely be amongst these 100 dresses only. And they were so beautiful that any one of the dress out of 100 could be the winner. The designs were so, so beautiful that there was no even competition. Other girls' drawings were not even standing anywhere in front of these dresses. So that's why I'm very happy to say that Wanda Petronsky is the winner of the girls' medal. So that was the announcement made by the teacher. And this is the girl. See how she would, you know, spend her quality time rather than wasting in gossiping. That's why I say it's up to you whether you want to just gossip about others or you want to channelize yourself. People keep on teasing you. People will keep on saying things to you, but it's up to you only how you, you know, take up the things. It takes courage to show your true colors. Unfortunately, now you can see various dresses, various gowns and middies and jackets and frills and trimmings, different designs. So this is actually talent. Unfortunately, Brenda has been absent from school for some days. So this is very unfortunate. When her name was announced, she was not present and is not here. You know that she has not been coming to school for a few days and is not here to receive the applause and is due to her. Everybody was clapping, whistling, and she was not there to see it. Let us hope she will be back tomorrow. So teacher says, let's see, maybe she will be coming tomorrow. Now class, you may file around the room quietly and look at her axicusite drawings, means extremely beautiful drawing. So let's have a look on the different dresses made by Vanda Petronsky. So the children burst into applause. Everybody was clapping, and even the boys were glad to have a chance to stamp on the floor, but put their fingers in their mouths and whistle. Though they were not interested in dresses, obviously boys, they always do like that. Though they were applauding, the way of applauding was different. Look, Peg, whispered Medi. There is that blue one she told us about. Isn't it beautiful? So now Medi is talking to Peggy that look, she always used to tell about the blue dress. Isn't it beautiful? Yes, said Peggy. And here is that green one, boy. And I thought I could draw. So Peggy is so amazed to see the collection of dresses. She is now saying that I thought I'm the only one who could draw better than others. But my God, what this girl has done is mind-boggling. Fine. So with this oral comprehension check now, why did not Medi ask Peggy? Let's have a look. Let's continue, then we'll do our question.
There were drawings all over the room. Dazzling and brilliant designs. Everybody was looking, nobody could mind.
It's time to announce the winners.
Miss Mason.
Jack Phoenix has won for the boys. As for the girls, all but just one or two stitches were submitted by men, one boy, and 13 shifted proud of them. It's actually 21 new designs. All different. How beautiful. In the opinion of the judges, anyone drawn is worthy of winning the prize. I am very happy to say that Ronald Petronsky is the winner of the girls' medal. Unfortunately, Ronald has been absent for school for some days. But let's hope she will get tomorrow. What happened? Well, exactly what she told us about. Isn't it beautiful? Yes. And there is the green one.
No. Both depends on when Wanda told me she has 100 dresses lined up in her closet. The bottom. But you see the second part of it.
Fine, so this was the answer why she would say she had 100 dresses. So our first question is, why did not Medi ask Peggy to stop teasing Wanda? Oral comprehension, beta. These questions I'm talking about, okay? Why did not Medi ask Peggy to stop teasing Wanda? What was she afraid of? Raise your hand. Jaldi se, Tanya. Yes, Tanya.
Medi didn't ask Peggy to stop teasing Wanda because she was afraid to get mocked off. If she would write it, then they would also get to know that she is also poor and does not have as much dresses as Peggy has and always borrows the hand-me-down clothes.
Right answer. We have already discussed this, right? So next, raise hand those who want to answer, then I would be unmuting you. Yes. Let me see the next question first. Who did Medhi think would win the drawing contest and why? Who won the drawing contest? What had the winner drawn? So both these questions. Yes, Divyansh. Quickly, beta.
Ma'am, Medhi thought that Peggy would
speak loudly.
Ma'am, Medhi thought that Peggy would win the drawing contest. She thought that Peggy drew better than anyone else in their class. Fine. Peggy was such an expert that she could copy the pictures alike.
Fine, you can mute yourself. So, beta, Medhi thought that definitely Peggy would win the drawing contest because she was very good at drawing. She could copy the pictures of from magazines exactly, and you can recognize the person whose picture she has drawn. So that's why Peggy was having wonderful drawing skills. That's why Medhi thought she would win this competition. And who won the drawing contest exactly? Actually, in reality, Vanda Petronsky won the drawing contest, and she had drawn 100 beautiful dresses of different designs and different colors. Any one drawing could make up her the winner. So that's why judges decided that Vanda Petronsky is the winner. Now, these questions. How is Vanda seen as different by other girls? How do they treat her? This question, beta, we have already discussed yesterday only, that Vanda was an American Polish girl. Her name was different. She lived at a different place, Boggins Heights. And that's why other girls would treat her differently. And they would tease her by asking the question, how many dresses did she have? How many shoes did she have? Fine, so then after that, they would make fun of her. How does Vanda feel about the dresses game? Why does she say that she has 100 dresses? So, anybody would, yes, Tanya, you can answer this question.
Vanda says that she has 100 dresses, but Vanda says that she has 100 dresses, but in actual, they were not 100 dresses. They were the drawings of 100 dresses which were lined up.
Fine. So Vanda would feel whenever anybody asked her that how many dresses did she have, she was giving answer that she had 100 dresses all lined up in her closet. And she was right because she was having drawings of all 100 dresses. That's why she would say that she had 100. Fine. So why does Medhi stand by and not do anything? Same question, beta. They have just molded it. Medhi would not say anything because she herself was very poor. She would think that if she stops her friend, next turn would be hers. She imagines herself to be mocked at by others. Fine. How is she different from Peggy? Why is she different from Peggy? Because she's not as poor. They have just asked the comparison of Medhi and Peggy. She's different from Peggy because Peggy was a rich girl having the different dresses, and Medhi was a poor girl who was wearing old clothes. And this difference, and second difference is Medhi was having empathy towards Vanda Petronsky. Peggy would make fun of Vanda, but Medhi never made fun of Vanda. She wanted to stop her friend, but she could not express herself. Okay, so she was different from her friend. She was much better than Peggy. What does Miss Mason think of Vanda's drawings? What do the children think of them? How do you know? So firstly, Miss Mason thinks that Vanda has done a wonderful job, and any one dress could be the winner out of the 100. And Vanda, then other children also applaud by whistling, by murmuring. And this is mentioned so that we come to know when everybody started applauding loudly for Vanda. Clear? So we have discussed question answers also. Bell is about to go. Beta, this is your homework. You will be doing the back exercises related to grammar, adverbs and all on your own. Okay, so this is your homework. We have discussed all the question answers. Any doubt to anyone about this chapter, you can ask me. Meet is going to be ended in a minute. No doubts are there? Okay, beta, have a nice day. and prepared this chapter along with Anne Frank for your subjective test we held on coming Monday. All the best with her.